Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good evening. Thank you very much for the time that given me. This moment, I want to present about the assignment under the guidance Mr. Dr. Teguh Sulistyo, MPD. And what kind of the title that we have to discuss? It's based on the LMS. So means learning management system. Hello Wansayat for share about our presenting. Yes, like here that you can look on the screen. It's based on the language and technological competency. Well, we know that Google Classroom, actually it is popular now since pandemic COVID-19 begin, because all of the teacher cannot have the classical like usually, but by using the Google Classroom, it can conduct it about the managerial for the students, and this process of learning and teaching in the school will be easy. We know that the classroom helps classes communicate and save time and stay organized. So we have to learn more about this. Google Classroom is part of G Suite and is linked to its feeders. So users also get access to Google Drive and Calendar, Jamboard, Form, Hangout, Mint, and Document, Sheet, Slide, and Gmail. And then yeah, it's very complete, okay? And then benefit by using the Google Classroom. We know that here are some things that you can do while studying online by using Google Classroom. So we can share and course about the material or syllabus, and then assign and submit or assignment, and hold exams and giving quizzes, as maybe we can use it for assessment, and then interactive by Q&A, and view upcoming text via Google Calendar. In addition to the various benefits above, Google Classroom is suitable as an option for the online learning because this platform is free. So we can download by using smartphone in Play Store. And then how to log in Google Classroom. Assign in the Google Classroom, of course, access with via browser. So we have to prepare our account, like Gmail like that, or email address that you want to use, change by using or the joining in Google Classroom. And then we can press the plus sign and then plus in the right corner after you download this app. Okay, so we can join. There are two choices. We want to join or meet as a teacher. But about the option, namely, is join class and quit class. If you are a teacher, so we can quit class, but if you are student, so we can join with this class. If you intend to join the class, select to join class. Enter the 7-digit class code that was given earlier. If you are a lecturer and the teacher has not provided a class code, I immediately ask for it, okay? And then if you already joined class, so you can see assignments or material shared by your teacher is during classwork. And then after we install it, and then how to create a Google Classroom like that. Yes, it is the same. We know that there are two points. We are going to the student or we are going to the teacher. If we are going to the teacher, so we can choose this plus sign by create a new classroom. Okay, after finish all, so we can What's that? Fill the class name and complete it about the section, subject, and room file. Okay, here, this classroom, if we are finishing for download it, so we can give the student about the assignment. If like that, when we share about the assignment, then here we know that two person can look at our assignment. Okay. And then the next, after the class is created, the Google Classroom will automatically generate class code. So you can share this, what's that, class code by, what's that, by inviting or sharing with the student, so they can join in the class. In the class section, we can upload some materials, give segment, or take quizzes. For the quizzes, because it is included with G Suite, so we can use the Google Form or quizzes or yes, another. And then to make easier and save time, quiz question and do not need to be typed one by one in question section. Make one file then upload by clicking Add. Okay, and don't forget to set the maximum score the student can get and deadline due to the click sign. After do the same things to give the text. In the form, we have list of question. Make one file, then upload it by clicking Add. Okay, and then don't forget to set the maximum score the student can get the add deadline and due to and then click as at the same. Okay, for grading, after we give the student assignment, so student submit the assignment, then you will be able to review and grade them. And Google Classroom give each assignment its own page, making it easy to grade and leave back a feedback for your students. Okay, to view assignment, you have two options. Start by navigating to the classwork tab and click assignment that you want to grade, and then click the view assignment. It's very simple and very easy. Another option is to click the grade tabs from there, then you can open the assignment you want to grade. Either option will take you student work page for the assignment. This is where you'll be able to view is for your student and submission and grade them. Yes, so we can look at this. It is finished for credit. It is on the assignment that it is turned in, means the student given or uploaded their assignment to the teacher. And then one way to get the student assignment is when the student work page, simple click and the score next to any student's name, and then type the grade you like to give. May after creating the assignment, you can select the checkbox beside each student's name and click return like that. So we can choose the name of the student that we want to grade. After that, we can give score or assessment here. If all become clearly and right, so we can give 100 in this section. Okay, next, and then grading segment with the grading tools. Yes, like what? Okay, we can look at this section. On the right side of the screen, you will find a column featuring and grading. Yes, in the grade part, you can type the grade that you like to give. You can also leave feedback for the student in the private commented file. And then after that, for finishing or maybe having multiple submission, once you have finished grading an assignment and are ready to share with the student, you can click return button. To view the other option, you can click the drop down arrow. Yes, drop down arrow like that. And then return the submission option, only return one grade at a time. And then if you have graded multiple assignment, the return multiple submission option can help you save time by returning grades to more than one student. Okay, I think it can be doing by the all same assignment to the all students. Then if we are want to give a comment to the student, we can write down here. A dialogue book will ask you to confirm that you want to return work or certain number of the students click. Okay. When you look the screen like that, so it means by the all of the student and all of the segment. So we can look at this. Which one the student cannot complete the segment, so we cannot create all. Okay, we can choose one by one and analyze who is finished and who is the who doesn't finish yet. Okay, to see overall grades, you will not return overall grades by calculation in this class setting. Okay, and then how about the overall grades calculation? To see particular students work, click on time name. You can see what they have turned in, what has been written, and they have are missing assignment. Okay, after that there is a like a presentation, how many percent that all the student have to have finished done yet. Okay, and then here the Google Classroom give you the ability to export grades from the assignments to Google Sheet, and to export grades for the assignment you have finished grading, go to the student's work page. Okay, click the gear icon and the top right and select copy of grades to Google Sheet. Okay, after that all finished, then we can was the create one of the spreadsheet. Okay, if the important to note that it will not update automatically whenever you update more assignment, you will need an export again. Okay, this in this section, this product can show in the Microsoft Excel. Okay, if you are looking for a more detail and customized and good book experience, there are plenty of that every playbook that work in conjunction with the Google Classroom. Okay, thank you very much. I think that's all for how to use the Google Classroom as a learning management system. That I use it for guide to my student in this class, because our learning process is online learning still in pandemic COVID-19. Thank you very much and see you.